Bennett is, he is just a great kid, like all around good kid. The thing that I love most about Ben, that he is very compassionate and he is very, you know, he feels, he's very empathetic, and I think that's hard to find these days. And he always amazes me, like if I'm having a bad day or and I talk to him about something, you know, he feels it and he interprets it and then he gives great advice.
I mean, to be honest, like I didn't really know what was like going on at all. Like I just, I didn't, if you told me like I had a brain tumor, like I would have been like, I kind of just was like, oh, okay. Like I, nothing really like changed in like my attitude or my energy, like of who I always am as like a person. Like, I don't really know if, it was, if I was only in seventh grade, that's why, or I just didn't really fully grasp what was like going on.
The emergency room doctor came to us and told us that that they were taking him for a CAT scan, and when she came back, not long, she told us that he had a mass on his brain, and his pain, his excruciating pain that he was in, was due to the mass was bleeding, and then you know our journey began at Albany Med.
I mean, it just knocks the wind right out of you. You really just, you know, think you're in a bad nightmare. It's just surreal. And, you know, things happen so fast around you and you just, you know, I mean, I lost it.
You know, we actually met in a boardroom with the team of neurosurgeons, and you know, they presented their case to us and told us how they were going to, you know, make Ben better, essentially, how they were going to remove the tumor, what they were going to do. They never guaranteed us that it wasn't malignant or was benign. They just told us, you know, the plan, and we felt from that moment on, that meeting, I'll never forget. That was. You know, as a parent, a very emotional meeting.
Yeah, very emotional. You know, any chance that we could get to have some peace in our hearts and minds, you know, we took every opportunity. And after meeting with the neurosurgeon, you know, we knew we had the right person for the job and we were in the right place.
The doctors were outstanding. The nursing staff at Albany Med was, like, couldn't ask for anything better. I remember I came back once from lunch and they like decorated my room a little bit. Like it felt like, you know, kind of like home.
I'm so proud of Bennett. You know, I'm proud of all my kids, you know, but I, you know, obviously Bennett went through something that is life changing and he has come through it on the other side tremendously with an amazing perspective. You know, we always tell him that, you know, what other kids are going through or what you're going through right now, think of where you've been. Think of the journey that you have been on. Yours is a journey that, thank God, not a lot of people have to experience, but look how great you've come out of it. We are so proud of him.
It really doesn't define who I am. And I always think to myself, like, hey, like, this can't be that bad. Like, I've done, like, I went through brain surgery with a brain tumor, you know, I could have been way worse, and I'm grateful because, you know, there's many other people that have it way worse than me in just their regular life and that have had the same situation and it didn't turn out for them this way. You know, thank God that it ended up this way for me, and I'm very grateful for that.
He kept us going, you know, instead it should have been the other way around, but we drew our strength from him. And it was just an amazing, amazing thing.
I mean, a quote that I always, it's my senior quote that I always look back on is, you know, treat the word impossible as nothing more than motivation. I always look at it like, you know, a brain tumor, you know, that could be an impossible thing, but, you know, you can get through it. Like, it's just should be more motivation for you to come out on the other side.
You know, we always say, that children's hospital is such a special place that you don't realize how fortunate we are in this area to have this children's hospital so close to us. And, you know, until you need it, you don't realize it. But once you need it, wow. And I want to say they are angels on earth that are doing these jobs, these nurses and these doctors in the Children's Center. Angels on earth. And it takes a very special person to do those jobs. And I'm just grateful that there's people that go into that field